Hey guys, welcome to KFC Korean Food Cookbang. It's easy and tasty Korean cooking channel, and I'm Eugene. It was Korean Thanksgiving Chuseok last Thursday. I was just going to skip this year, but suddenly I just want to invite my family. Actually, it was such a last minute decision to make something festive dish for Chuseok, but I want to have at least galbijjim, which is Korean traditional braised beef short ribs. It usually takes a long time and a lot of ingredients needed, but this time I don't have enough vegetables and no time to go to shop. So I will make something easier but still taste good galbijjim. And I want to share that recipe to you guys. I know you want to follow my recipe. So as always, I put all the ingredients and links on the description of the video. So take a look, okay? Oh, so let's get started before they come, okay? First of all, put the short ribs into the water to remove excess blood. It takes about 2 hours. And then make the sauce for braising. Add 2 cups of soy sauce. One cup of cooking wine and 2/3 cup of sugar. Four tablespoons of minced garlic. And 3 teaspoons of ginger powder. And 2 cups of water. And then we also need 2 cups of chopped green onions. And add 4 tablespoons of sesame oil. And mix them well. Now put the short ribs into the large pot. And then pour the sauce over the ribs. Add 1 liter. Of water. It's approximately like 4 cups of water. And start to cook with a high flame. While it's cooking, now let's prepare some vegetables. I only had 3 potatoes, but you can use more potatoes if you have. The cooking is done slowly, so be patient. When the sauce with the ribs are boiling, there is some kind of meat forms will appear. Just use a ladle to remove it. It takes about an hour until the ribs get soft and tender. I forgot to put sesame oil to the sauce earlier, so I'm free now. Now add all the vegetables to the pot when the meat is almost cooked. Let it boil more. And please don't forget to taste your food. So if it's too salty, add some more water. And if it's too bland,
add some more soy sauce, okay? Keep removing the foams if you can. It looks already so good.
My galbi jjim turned out great and everyone loved it. So if you just followed my recipe, I'm sure you also successfully done. I hope you had a great galbi jjim. And if you liked it, please press the like button and subscribe me for the next video. I think this is it for today. Thank you for watching my video. See you next time. Bye!